Well, hello everyone. Hello and welcome to the webinar. It's a beautiful day here. We are about to start in a minute or two. I'm here in Australia, and Brill, who will join us for this webinar, he's in the United States with his team. And we have viewers who are all over the world. So it really is a very exciting moment. So before we start, just two very, very quick questions. First, can everyone hear me? Now, can you please put yes into the chat box if you can hear me? Okay, perfect, wonderful, wonderful. There is a slight delay or a second or two, you know, before I can see your messages. So that's great, and I only have one more question, and that one is, are you already involved in the on-demand TV industry in one way or another? Okay, and it seems that we have some yeses, and you know, there are some people saying no. But this is excellent, excellent. Well, let me just open my slides. So let's put a slide on, and I'm going to switch off my webcam so that you can see what is going on. And yes, for people who are already in the TV industry one way or another, I think that there will be lots of things to take from this webinar, things that you can apply immediately, things that you can start using. And for people who are new to the industry, I think that you are going to learn quite a lot. So lots of materials to go through. I was thinking of maybe waiting for a minute or two for everybody else to come, but I think that we'd better get started, because with so much information that I would like to share with you, I don't really want to go over time with this webinar. So welcome, welcome, welcome. As usual, well, there will be lots of notes to take. We have lots of ground to cover. So please make sure that there are no distractions around you. You don't want your mobile phone to distract you, know, five times with various messages and phone calls during the presentation. It's today a big pleasure to introduce to you Brill Oshia from iRank Locally. And that's the team of automation specialists. They grew to a $16 million company, $16 million company. So today we have the honor of seeing their latest creation, which is called Nano Express, which gives you everything that you need to create, to manage, and importantly, to hugely automate your own and your clients' TV channels on Apple TV, on Roku, on Amazon Fire TV, and Google Chromecast will follow next. So it's just around the corner. Brill, hello, are you there?
Yes, I'm here. I'm here.
Fantastic. Why is it called Nano Express? Well, for a very simple reason. This is the software that combines many, many little tasks, nano tasks, into producing some really big results. So you're what I'm going to talk about this, and what Brill is going to talk about. You're going to learn quite a lot about the state of the on-demand TV industry. I will also give you the pathway into the future. You will learn about the challenges, and but also about the opportunities for you and for your clients. I have to tell you, this is not going to be your typical presentation. First, because I want to give you lots of up-to-date information. And secondly, I have to admit, you know, there is no denying it, I'm not a very good marketer. I know enough to get by, But that's about it. I mean, on the planet, there would be have to be a huge number of people who are much better marketers than I am. So instead of pushing your emotional buttons, well, today I will be giving you the facts. And there are so many facts that I really had to remind myself when I was putting the presentation together. Hey, I better make one slide about the price, because there is a special for you today that I will be talking about during the presentation. And speaking of which, I know that some people always leave when the price is mentioned because they think that that's the end of the informative bit and start of the pitch. But you know, guys, my fellow web warriors, this is not your typical webinar, which means that I will be giving you the knowledge that you can use up until the last minute. So even if you never end up using NanoExpress, there will be lots that you can truly use here. Okay, now. I'd like to share a story with you of how it all started. And a few years back, I was really spending lots and lots of time trying to do something with social media marketing. And I was finding it quite hard because I had enough products. I had developed enough software. But what really was missing was I wanted lots of people to get to know about that software and to start using that software. So I started looking at social media. And what I very quickly found out is that it is an enormous time sink. I mean, I could easily spend hours and hours without even noticing, but the results were just not all that impressive. Okay, I mean, you're building relationships, but it is all going very, very slow when you are there and you are typing all of those messages and responding to people yourself. And at that stage, my good friend Brian, who is also my business partner, he told me something that really started at all. He said, you know, there is Roku that is quite popular in the United States, and maybe we should also do something about that. They apparently are involved in TV on demand. So, well, sure enough, you know, I haven't heard about Roku before. He was the one who introduced me to Roku and to the on-demand TV. But I thought, all right, well, I'm wasting so much time, you know, on social media and I'm getting nowhere, so I might as well try to see what this is all about. And what I, of course, knew and what we all know is that TV business is big business and that, you know, entire fortunes have been made over there. But Roku, you know, to have your own TV channel and to do something with your own TV channel, well, that up until that moment did not cross my mind. So I was intrigued, though. So, and I wanted to check the facts. And so what are the facts? Well, in regard to Roku, it is the world leader in the on-demand TV. There are over 38 million users per week. The average viewer would spend over 50 hours per month watching Roku. And the Roku's share of the US over the top, sorry, there is a typo there, so it's not ever the top, it's over the top device video market is 49%. So they single-handedly have almost half of the market. The company value is 1.3 billion. And those facts, you know, were quite encouraging. I wanted to know more. I wanted to see, you know, are they growing? Is that the industry that is growing? Well, today I can tell you that the battle is already over. And the fixed-time TV lost, on-demand TV won. There are less and less people who are willing to go and watch the fixed-time TV. They want to be able to switch on their favorite shows, watch the movies at the time of their choosing. And for that reason, you know, the number of on-demand viewers now surpasses big time the number of fixed-time TV viewers. That is not going to change. The difference is just going to become bigger. And when it comes to Roku, you know, this is a company that is clearly growing big time. Just look at that, from 5.5 billion hours in 2015, people watching Roku, it went to 9 billion. The next year went to 14 billion. The year after, 24 billion hours in 2018. That's how many hours people spent watching Roku channels. So we are talking about the industry that is rapidly growing. And whenever you have the industry that is rapidly growing, it's a bit of an opportunity. Revenue, 742.5 million in 2018, and that is up from 530 million in 2017. So clearly, you know, the growing industry. When I started, well, I didn't have all of this information because I updated, you know, that with the latest couple of years. But on the other hand, I knew more than enough to know that that is quite a significant opportunity and that I would really like to be a part of it. So there is absolutely no doubt that Roku was growing. So what happened next? Well, when you look at that, you know, there aren't really that many keys to online business success. You want a growing market whereby the demand is high, but the supply is low. You want traffic, because with traffic, really nothing happens. You want the authority, and you want some easy way to monetize all of that traffic and the authority that you're gaining. And apparently, in this industry, really, you have it all. Now, this is the market that is growing exponentially. The traffic, well, I'm going to tell you in a moment about my experience when it comes to traffic. The authority, well, it most definitely builds authority. You will find out that the doors start opening up for you, and people find it very hard to say no to you once they know that you're running TV channels. And when it comes to easy monetization, well, back then there were not really that many channels. And so monetizing the channels was just incredibly easy. Why is it that there were not so many channels? Because it was absolutely necessary to build your channel in BrightScript, which is the programming language that Roku developed. Not very many people could do it. So I created my first channels by sitting down and doing all the programming work, brought three of the channels to start with. What you see here is the screenshot from one of them. It's called Guitar School. And within the first week alone, I had more than 10,000 people who signed up for the channel. This cumulative, the number of cumulative installs that you see, this shot was taken a couple of days ago, so it's probably over 150,000 now. A couple of days ago, it was 149,405 installs. Now, that's a pretty big number of installs. And if you were going to pay for the same number of clicks, for example, if you were advertising on Google by using pay-per-click pay-per-click advertising, well, let me tell you, it would cost you really quite a lot. It would cost you an arm and a leg to have this many people come to the website. And here we are talking about something much better, because people are not just coming, they are actually putting their channel, putting your channel on their Roku device and watching it day in and day other and day out. And you have to keep in mind that for every install, there would be more than one member of the family watching it. And so the real number of people watching your channel is considerably bigger than the number of installs that you see over there. That worked very, very well for me. So what I did then was I decided to make that software available to my clients as well. And that's how Inspired.vision was born. That was the BrightScript application that would allow people to launch their own TV channels to run ads. What I did with my channel, I was running the TV ads over there, and with the Guitar School, I was also using that to boost my book sales, because I have a number of guitar books that are published on Amazon, and people were finding about those books through the videos. So that was an excellent way to get people to know about those books, to hear the music, and to start buying the books as well. Very, very easy way to monetize it. What I found out, however, when I started Inspire.Vision.ITV was that my clients, the super users, and some of them very quickly became super users always make a lot more money than software makers. So especially with the very next version, which was TV Boss, which I launched when Roku introduced the direct publisher format. I very, very quickly switched to the direct publisher format. Now, why is that? Because, you know, with the Bright Script, those applications are really quite good. But on the other hand, Roku makes lots and lots of changes all the time to their software development kit. And so if I then had to recompile and recode the application each time there is a change for each one of my clients, well, that was just too time-consuming, it was too expensive, and just not very practical. With a direct publisher, I could create, you know, the software that would work with that directly, called TV Boss, and that would allow you to, you know, launch and manage the content of your channel. Everything was much simpler, and consequently, you know, lots of people started doing extremely well out of that software. They very, very quickly became super users. And then they would go back to me and they would say, hey, I just made my first $5,000 with TV Boss. Some people who had more marketing talent than I did, they were easily making $10,000 in their first deal, which I found, you know, quite amazing. What happened then? Well, TV Boss version 3, that's something that I launched with Craig Crawford as my marketing manager. And finally, TV Boss Fire. Well, Craig by this time took over, and he is now the one and the only owner of the TV Boss projects. His team did the programming of TV Boss Fire, and I did the project management. So, in other words, I went full cycle from being fully engaged and having 100% of TV Boss down to having 0%. And being disengaged. So I'm no longer involved in the TV Boss. The younger generation took over, but I'm very proud of what was accomplished. And thanks to the accumulated knowledge and the experience, I'm now in the great position to tell you exactly where things are today and give you the pathway into the future. So here is a bit of a change of pace with this slide. This is my little daughter, Sia, who is 2 years old, who you see in this picture. And this is the beach, which is about 5 minutes from where we live. We live in Adelaide, in Australia, 5 minutes away from one of the most beautiful beaches in the world. I mean, people work all year and then they pay top dollar to spend, you know, a week in a place like this. But we live here. And we love it. Sia, my daughter, she loves going to the beach, and so do I. But this is not the reason why I'm showing you this slide. Now, if you pay attention and just look at the bench on which Sia is sitting, you will see that it's full of solar cells. While you are resting your bum, there is a charger there that will wirelessly charge your phone and all the other devices. And we are talking about a bench in a park. To me, this represents change, and a really big change. We live at the times of rapid changes. If someone were to tell me, you know, 10 years ago that, hey, you would just walk into your park and there is going to be a bench with solar cells that is going to wirelessly recharge your devices, Well, I think that I would look at that pretty much like on fiction, but that's reality. And with this industry, with the on-demand TV, very, very quickly, there were lots of changes. So what I wanted to tell you is something about those changes, something about the challenges that are very much present today, and also about some of the opportunities that were not there before. So first of all, the very big thing is the direct publisher format. That means that there are a lot more players than before, a lot more players, because it is considerably cheaper and considerably easier to go into the market. When it comes to traffic, well, because the barriers of entry were quite significant at the beginning, that means that I could easily get 10,000 people in the first month alone, 10,000 people, simply because the channel was there. No other reason. However, it is now down to about 3,500 people for the first month alone. So that means that when you open the channel these days, you get less people, and that's because there are more people opening the channels. The demand is still skyrocketing. The demand is still going up, as you could see in one of my previous slides. But at the same time, it is also true that there are more channels satisfying that demand. And for that reason, you have the diluted advertising dollar. They're less, there are a little bit less opportunities for you because there are so many other channels that are out there. And that means that rather than having heaps of people coming to you only, they're coming to those other channels as well. What you have to keep in mind is that Roku just launched their TV advertising. I was in the very first wave of people to sign the agreement with them. And back then, I could get the rates of between $12 and $16 per 1,000 ad displays. I don't think that they do those deals anymore, except with channels that are exceptionally popular. I think that the standard deal these days would be about $10 for 1,000 ad displays. And in some cases, when you do it with other companies, it goes down to $6 per 1,000 ad displays. But on the other hand, you know, companies like Barron's Media, and I know people in there personally, and I've been working with them. So even though they usually give you less than $10 per 1,000 ad displays, they have considerably better inventory coverage, which means that rather than people watching a big percentage of your videos for free, well, they are able to provide you better coverage than that Roku TV can. So what happened next? Well, ratings. Back then, no one was talking about the ratings. But these days, because there are lots of channels, lots of advertisers, they are insisting of your channel having at least 100 five-star ratings before they want to do business with you, before they want to put their ads there. That is definitely more difficult. When it comes to Roku, when it comes to Amazon and Amazon Fire TV, they are becoming more picky. Because in the past, you could easily have, you know, calls to action all over the place. You could have the invitations for people to come to your website all over the place. Well, now they're often saying you cannot do that because you are being too promotional. And if they think that your channel is too promotional, well, they will really refuse to publish it. Or if it's already published, they can take it down. They're definitely becoming more picky. Vimeo. Well, when I was starting with the Vimeo Pro plan, you could have unlimited bandwidth. Well, now you also have unlimited bandwidth on the Vimeo Pro plan, but only when you're using the Vimeo player. And guess what? You know, I'm talking about using Vimeo for hosting the videos, of course, that are being streamed on the TV channels that I'm creating. Video Pro is still a reasonably good solution. But on the other hand, if your channel becomes very popular, that means that lots of bandwidth will go not on the Vimeo player, but lots of bandwidth will go by playing your videos directly on places such as Roku, such as Amazon Fire TV. Vimeo will not like it. And there were people who started having traction. They were starting to get ads and starting to get pretty good revenue out of this. And all of a sudden, Vimeo would turn around and they would say, hey, you know, you're generating too much bandwidth. You need to go to the custom plan. And a custom plan, well, in the extreme case, in the case of a lady who was generating 2 terabytes a day, they wanted to put her on a custom plan that was $15,000 per year. There were a number of people who Vimeo wanted to put on a custom plan of $3,000 per year and everything in between. So this is really not a terribly good development. It makes it harder for you to earn the advertising dollar. And at the same time, even though Roku is still the leader, there are others who are entering the fray. There are others who are competing for the same market. Now, at the moment, Amazon Fire TV is second. Apple TV is third. And I'm going to tell you quite a bit about Apple TV in a moment. Google Chromecast is also, they have also entered the scene. And so these are the big four: Roku, Amazon, Apple TV, and Google Chromecast. Several proven strategies stopped working as a result of those changes. But on the other hand, there were also opportunities that opened up, again, as a result of those changes. Well, first of all, you know, what's the big opportunity? Yes, with direct publisher format, there are more players in the game. But, you know, previously, I had to switch between BrightScript applications simply because I could not automate it. Well, what Brill and his team are doing, with the very next version, it will be possible to actually go back from the direct publisher format and have, you know, the application being in BrightScript, which is only possible due to automation. There would be absolutely no way, you know, to go on and do all of that manually. But with a team, you know, that specializes in automation, well, that something like that is very, very much possible. Why would that format be any better than the direct publisher format? Well, for more than one reason. Well, first, with a direct publisher format, it is currently not possible to do in-app purchases. So if you want people to simply use their Roku remote and click, do a purchase, well, you are unable to do that with the direct publisher format. But you certainly can do it with a BrightScript format. Another pretty big thing over there is that with a BrightScript format, you can do other things that are really not possible with the direct publisher format. You can have more videos. You are not limited to the number of videos that the direct publisher can support. There are also big advantages when it comes to the ways how you can organize your videos and other advantages that we will be talking in more detail now. I can't go into it now, otherwise we would spend a lot more time. But the fact that it can be automated means that you can now gain a significant advantage over the others. Second, when it comes to traffic, well, with the social media automation that is coming, well, it will be possible to automate promotions that you're running on social media that can help you for your channels, for your websites, for many other things. And I think that with the some of the opportunities that are opening up over there, you can actually go a lot more than 10,000 installs in the first month. When it comes to the diluted advertising dollar, well, let me tell you, the average channel on Roku, the average channel on Amazon Fire TV would have about 30 to 40 videos. So between 30 and 40 videos. And that is largely because, you know, so many things have to be done manually. Well, when it comes to this particular piece of software, Nano Express, with that you can automate everything to the point where you can easily come to 1,000 videos in your channel, which is the maximum for the direct publisher format. And you know what? Well, then the diluted advertising dollar is actually going to work in your favor, because your website is, your channel is going to be able to offer a lot more than other channels. It will work a lot better for you. And with more videos into the system, with a better promotion, more people finding about you, the ratings will be there to follow as well. Vimeo, well, when it comes to Vimeo, yes, that is a problem, but I'm very happy to say that Brill and his team have been working on a solution, and it is really not far away. Brill will be able to tell you quite a bit more about this in a moment. But what I can tell you is that you won't have to worry about going over the bandwidth and paying thousands of dollars. That's not going to happen. You will have a very clear situation when it comes to on-demand videos, and also when it comes to the live video, which is another option that is also coming. One other thing is that even though Roku is still the leader, the others are catching up. It's not all that clear who is going to win the game. And there are big advantages in being on all of those places at once. So in other words, having a number of channels that are working not just on Roku, but on Amazon Fire TV, on Apple TV, on Google Chromecast, and using the strategies that we are going to tell you that we know work and that are somewhat different than the strategies that were used in the past. The opportunity is still there. And in my view, the opportunity is actually a lot bigger than before. The number of people who are watching on-demand TV is a lot bigger. It is also possible to go for more than one platform now when it comes to on-demand TV. In the past, it was incredibly difficult just to be on one platform, let alone on more than one. But thanks to the automation, you can now run multiple channels as if it were a single channel, and you can run it in a tiny fraction of a time compared to you doing it manually. So while it might be a little bit trickier to find the direction of where the opportunities are, we know exactly where they are. And you know, Brill and his team, they're going to share that with you. Some of the strategies, well, we don't really have time for all of them, but some of them when it comes to the way forward. One thing that this piece of software that you're going to see in a moment really introduces is the simplicity. And another thing is that Apple TV, let me tell you about Apple TV. They are the relative newcomer onto the scene. So here are some of the facts you know. Roku is the industry leader. It's not Apple TV. Apple TV is the latecomer to the on-demand market. The others were there before them. To have your own channel, well, that was not allowed at first. I think that was one of the things that held them back. Publishing channels on Apple TV is generally considerably more complicated than publishing channels elsewhere. And they're very particular about the way that needs to be done. So really not everybody can do it. Then there is a split. There are really two Apple TVs. One is Apple TV HD, which is 1080p, and the other one is Apple TV 4K, which gives you the highest resolution streaming available today. Next, you know, the Apple devices are quite expensive. You have to pay quite a bit of money for them. And because they're very particular about the way you need to run your channel, that makes everything a bit more difficult. So why bother with Apple? Is that really an opportunity? Because yes, well, we know that Nano Express now supports creating Apple TV channels. But having all of that in mind, you know, is that something that you really want to get yourself into? So here are some of the things that perhaps you did not know about. In the first quarter of this year, which is January, February, and March, Apple TV was the highest growing platform with 709% increase in the viewing hours in the first quarter of this year. Now, in the same period, Roku had the 87% increase in the same period. So remember, Roku is the leader. However, if Apple can maintain those rates, and they're certainly quite popular, putting lots of money into it, I think that their chances of overtaking Roku or catching up would be pretty good. The fact that things are difficult when it comes to Apple, that creates the barrier of entry, which really for you is a big plus, because Nano Express allows you to do is it gives you incredible simplicity when it comes to creating your channels, and in particular creating your Apple TV channels as well and running them. You don't even have to pay $99 for the developer account, because you know Brill and his team, they're the certified Apple developers, and so they cut through all the problems that are there with creating channels, and they just make it incredibly simple, or rather as simple as it possibly can be when it comes to Apple. Because of all this, you still have a very low level of competition. Users of Apple products are typically very wealthy, and they're also very faithful to Apple and their products. You would be hard pressed to find, you know, other people who would camp in front of the Apple store when a new product comes out. You know, they managed to build a very faithful audience. And for that reason, the advertisers or of more expensive brands, the brands that are being promoted on Apple TV, they're willing to pay more, and having your channel there gives you and your clients lots of prestige. So that means that, you know, there are big, big advantages of dealing with the Apple TV. By the way, because of all of those other difficulties, I'll give you a couple of examples. You have a channel like Instant TV, channel.com, channel maker. They're very, very successful when it comes to Roku. They managed to find quite a number of clients who are paying $49.95 per month, which is $594 per year, to run a single commercial channel, but only on Roku. We are not talking about multiple platforms. And they did not venture to go into multiple platforms because it is not an easy thing to do. So even though they have been doing quite well by providing services for creating Roku channels, they did not venture into Apple TV. They did not venture into other platforms. Vimeo, however, did. So when it comes to having, you know, your presence on multiple platforms, it is possible to do it through Vimeo. And this is something that I took off of the Vimeo website when it comes to their over-the-top solutions. You can get started for free, but you get next to nothing when you get started for free. This is the next available plan for Vimeo OTT. Yes, it does give you a number of platforms on which you can run your channel, but the cost is $500 per month. That amounts to $6,000 per year, which in my view is quite a lot. And we are talking about one single channel only, just one channel. Okay, now that channel runs on multiple platforms, but it is one channel. If you want two channels, it is double this amount of money per month. And at the same time, you can run your channel on multiple platforms. But let me show you what is it that this $500 plan does not give you. It does not give you the dedicated account manager. It does not give you the advertising support. It does not give you the full API so that you can take the full advantage of it. It does not give you the advanced integrations. It does not give you the uptime commitment or the digital rights management. And by the way, this is also the screenshot taken from the same video website, from the same video page as the previous one. So yes, they give you something for those $500. There are lots of things that they do not give you, and they want you to go to the custom plan and pay them a lot more in order to get those features that are listed here. Well, would it still be possible to make money and go for such expensive plans? Well, I would say yes. Vimeo, they're known in this particular industry as being among the cheapest. But on the other hand, I'm not sure that it would be incredibly easy because, you know, this is a major commitment. This is lots of money. However, suppose that you could also run your channels on multiple platforms, not just for yourself, but also for your clients. Let's suppose that you also have the level of automation that is unprecedented. No one else gives you that, not even Vimeo. And that you only go for the tiny, tiny fraction of this price that they're charging. Well, I think that then we are talking about a very different situation. Live streaming, I wanted to tell you a thing or two about the live streaming, but I think I will let Brill cover that in a moment or two. That is definitely coming. But what exactly do you need to succeed? I mean, okay, the opportunity is there. Doing all of those channels manually would be a nightmare. It would just be, you know, too hard. Because even though there are huge benefits to being present on multiple channels and having, you know, multiple channels on multiple platforms for multiple clients is a great thing. Without the automation, well, not an easy way to do. However, with the automation, it's a completely different picture. Because first of all, you're saving a huge amount of your time through automation. Secondly, you're going for the existing solutions. You're not going to reinvent the wheel. Instead, you're integrating with the existing systems. You're integrating with YouTube, with many other systems through one piece of software only that does the entire integration of all the existing solutions. Monetization, what you need is the crystal clear offer that people immediately understand. And once you do, then really it's not a problem at all monetizing your TV business. When it comes to Brill himself, it's really incredible that even before this product is officially launched, he already has users, and that with only a couple of years in place, he himself managed to build the income of between $13,000 and $14,000 per month in almost no time at all. And Brill, let me tell you, is not a marketer. He is a software developer. He is a programmer. Now, his company does have a terrific marketing department. And of course, they're going to help you every step of the way. But what I'm trying to say here is that you really do not need lots of fluff, lots of marketing, when the proposition is crystal clear, when people can look at it and say, you know, in a second, yes, that's exactly what I would like to go for. So what is it that you need in order to launch Apple TV, Roku, and Fire TV channels? It turns out that you only need three things. One is the Nano Express software, and in a moment, Brill will be running a demonstration of it. The second thing is you need whatever device is it that you're supporting, so the Roku device, the Apple TV, the Fire TV. And finally, you need a place to host your videos. And when it comes to web hosting, yes, well, that is going to be in no time at all part of the Nano Express solution as well. Even though if you host your videos elsewhere, let's say you're on Vimeo or somewhere else, that does not present a problem because this piece of software can really work with all of that. But I've been using this word automation quite a lot. So what is it that you're really automating? Well, how about, you know, I give you some scenarios. Well, let's say that you want to move your video or to share your video on more than one of your channels. Well, let's say that you have a channel about dogs, such as Dog Kingdom, which is my channel, and then you have another channel which talks about, you know, funniest video shows. Well, if you have the video that is about a funny dogs, well, that's the video that would naturally go into both of those channels. Well, let me tell you, click, click, and it's not in one channel, it is now shared in two channels, three channels, or more channels. Duration, do you want to calculate the duration manually? The program does it for you. Bitrate, it picks up the bitrate automatically. Thumbnail image, it generates it automatically. The intro that you put into the video, it adds it automatically. The outro that goes after the video, it adds it automatically. The credits, it also does that, and so on. Or how about this, you know? You supply the link to the Creative Commons video, let's say on Vimeo, and Nano Express checks it that it's the Creative Commons license. It then grabs it, downloads it, it adds the intro, it adds the outro, it adds the credits, it puts the video into the category or the number of categories. Now, if you want to bring the resolution down to 720p to save on bandwidth, it will do that as well. It calculates the duration automatically, it calculates the bitrate automatically, it generates the thumbnail, it uploads the video, it updates the feed for all of your channels. And what does it take to do all of this? It takes one click. It doesn't take hours. It takes literally one click. And if you're impressed, well, guess what? You can do not just that, but you can supply a text file with a whole bunch of videos and do not just one video like this, but a whole bunch of them. So can you see how easy would it be to have channels that have 1,000 videos in there rather than just 30 to 40, which is usually the case? Well, what I can tell you is that I'm a software engineer with a PhD in computer and information technology. I've been programming professionally since 1991. I have seen it all. And I'm still mightily impressed with what you can do with this piece of software. Of course, you also need to supply the content, which can be your own videos, it can be Creative Commons videos, it can be partnering with other people. And by the way, if you partner with someone on YouTube, well, with the functionality that this piece of software provides, you can actually have their channel running on Roku and elsewhere in no time whatsoever. You won't have to manually download their videos. It's all automated. You can go and purchase the content. And there is another great way to go about it that we are going to save only for people who are actually the Nano Express users. And with that in mind, Brill, could you please take over and tell us about your marketing department? Show us what the software can do.
Absolutely. Thanks, everybody, for coming out. Just real quick, I'm going to share my screen. This is just one slide, and then we're going to get into the demo of the software. But what this is I wanted to show, you know, you guys, with the product comes an entire company. We are an entire company here in Grove City, Ohio. And not only will you get a special sort of back end and documents and contracts and all those things, you'll actually, there'll be live conversations with us through chat. We have a bunch of wiki material, but we also, for the people that own the suite package, you'll actually have one of our marketing reps here that are assigned to you, and you'll talk to them on the phone. They'll help you with all your marketing plans. But the people that don't have that, they still have access to these people in our members area. And what we do is we lay out the strategies that we put forward using the automation that has become successful for us. And then they package it all up. They make little marketing materials out of it, and they put the contracts and documents together. And then they actually teach people that have the automation software to replicate that. So I just wanted to show that how we'd work with you. There's tons of support. Not my department, as you know, as Dr. Alex made very clear, I'm in the software side, so I'm actually here to demo the application itself. And so I am going to launch that now. I'm going to make sure everybody can see my screen. Hopefully you guys can see it. This is actually the Nano Express automation platform. Now, just really quickly, I'm going to go over sort of just high level what it does. We have tons of videos, and we've even pushed more out today. It's actually at Nano Express Training on Roku. We also have a Fire channel that's going to be approved and an Apple channel. But right here on the front screen, you know, you can add, you can resize videos with this check mark. Uncheck it if you don't want it. 7-minute ad rolls. You can check Creative Commons. He was alluding to that. Dr. Alex was alluding to that earlier. You can set your video privacy. So if you're the third party you're using, let's say it's Vimeo, you know, they, you can set videos private or public. So you have that option. Here's where all your channels and everything would be, and you can create them. You see right now I have Bigfoot Hunters and Homebrewing. I'm going to make a channel just called A Channel. And I'm just going to create it. And then it's going to go to this screen, which is our processing screen. And then what the processing screen is actually going to do is just go ahead and build out all the files. You'll notice that it's running these JS files. Those are JavaScript files that are specifically used for Apple. So as you set up a channel, it's actually putting in everything that you need on that channel to get it ready to go on multiple platforms. But you see it's done. It's built it all, and you have one Roku feed. I'll show you how to get the other feeds. It's quite simple. But by default, when you make a channel, you have the Roku feed. Now, if you wanted to post something to that channel, you just select it. You can either upload content from your local computer. If you did that, for example, if I was to go do this, I would just pick any video, and I'd hit load video. And since it's local on my machine, it's only going to grab the information it knows. ID assigns, duration, bit rate. It also makes the thumbnail automatically, and it resizes it to the correct size for whichever channel you're posting to. And then, of course, you say, I want to put it on a channel, and I'll put it in any folder that I want to put it in. And I put a title, description, tag, pick a category, and just hit save. Everything's done for you. That's one way to go about it. I can grab links from external sources. Doesn't really matter where the source is. If you grab something that is a video link to a web page that already has like descriptions and tags and categories like YouTube, everything happens. Thank you, Stephen. I'll slow down with the clicking. Everything will happen automatically. It'll bring in the tags. It'll bring in the metadata, all this information. If it doesn't, it'll bring in the video, and basically you'll have to go in there and add title or tag or description if it's not available on the site where you pulled the data from. Now, let's say you're going to just post to Bigfoot Hunters, and I want the tag because this will be where we'd actually make the category tag. Maybe I make this Bigfoot, and so every video I bring in have this tag so it could associate with one of the channels. So down here at the bottom, I think Dr. Alex was also talking about that. I could take a string of files, and on my desktop, I basically have a text file that has a couple items in it. So if I go to my desktop and just say haiku, I could hit publish, and this would just publish that. Right now there's only two items in it, but there could be 2, 20, 50, it doesn't matter how many are in there. I can override everything in the center. So it's pretty simple. If you ever mess anything up, you can hit this restore feed. And the window will come up and it'll say, hey, you're restoring feed on Bigfoot Hunters. Is that what you want to do? You hit yes. And it'll take back to your last successful update. So if you ever have a problem, with the press of a button, it'll automatically fix. So if you're in a situation like, let's say you have a Fire Roku channel and you know you have 7 or 8 videos posted, but you go on there and there's only 2 or 3 posted. I mean, I'll show you the tools you can use in this application to fix that, or you can just restore back and try to re-add them. So there's a lot of great features on this first page that'll automate any kind of uploading you want to do. Edit is another great option here. So let's say you have a channel. Let's say you have Bigfoot Hunters, and let's say you have a video on Bigfoot Hunters called 15 True Terrifying Whatever, and I want that to be on this channel as well. I could share that file, and in just a minute, that file would now be on both channels. I could move the files. I could delete the files. It all happens automatically. Channel editor. If you launch this, these are the channels that currently are supported. So if I was to go into a channel and I would select a channel, I could actually put a title in here, you know, and I could put an upload of image in here, and it'll automatically resize the image to whatever I want it, to whatever it needs to be. So this was converted to 114:114, and I could save this. The minute I save this, it's building the Apple channel, I mean the Fire channel in this case. So if I go and close this, and I close this and go back to the home screen and I find a channel and I look at my feeds, it's going to tell you that it's got a Fire feed as well as a JSON for Roku. So then you just have to go to Fire Creator and paste that in there. Now every time I put a video on a channel, it'll go to both of those feeds. That works with Apple as well, Roku, obviously Vimeo. These are the ones we have in development, Android, Chromecast, and all these will be live in the next one. So you'll be able to share it with social media as well as, different TV providers. This will include if you have the correct streaming. I mean, if you have the correct video hosting, you'll be able to live stream to the different options. And I know some of you are probably thinking, you know, but Instagram only allows a 10-second or 60-second video. Well, our system automates what can be shown, provided by what the third party is allowing. So it would all happen for you. And if you have a video and you need to edit it, you know, you can just go into the channel. You can pick any video you want. You can load the video. And here it is. So you can change everything, including the cover shot. It's automatically made for you. You don't have to, you know, these thumbnails were actually auto made from the software, but you can change them and just hit save and post to move it up. What you can't change is over here, because this was read by the software and this is actually the duration and bit rate. So obviously we don't let you change it in case it's an issue. Nano Developer. So inside here, I know some of you guys are used to working with the JSONs, and I know you're used to working with XML. So if you pick Bigfoot Hunters and I load that feed, it's going to bring that entire feed into my editor here. Now, what's cool about the editor is, let's say you're getting new to this, you're like, oh, no, I need to change this URL. So let's say you were to paste this URL in, but you forgot to put this comma. Well, if you were to push this feed up to Roku or to, you know, this is JSON, so it'd go to Roku, you'd probably see in the back where there'd be an error for your status. But with ours, let's say we want to upload it. It says, oh, no, you can't you can't upload because it's wrong. So until it's corrected, that's the only time you can actually update it. So if you do make a mistake, the system will not allow you to post it. I know everybody's talking about a lot of lag, so I'll try to slow it down. But this is the actual feed where you can manipulate the feeds for different channels. I can also say Bigfoot Hunters, show me the XML feed. And if there is an XML feed, it will load. I'm not sure there is though. Okay, what I'm gonna try to do is I'm gonna try to close everything down just for 1 second. And then I am going to try to, relaunch it real fast, and hopefully that will take care of some of the lag. So give me 1 second. Okay. Let me see here. Okay. So let me see. So let's go to merge videos. I see that has changed on my screen. Has it changed on everybody else's screen? Well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to still demonstrate it. Hopefully you guys can see the screen. Okay, so some of you, yes, some of you may be on slower connections or there might be internet problems. Okay, so now what this does is I know it's labeled intro, outro, and credits, but it actually automates putting in your, it marries multiple videos together. So if we go and look at some video, like I can actually pick an intro file and I can say my video, use this as the intro. Okay. I can say use this as the outro. Okay. I can say use this as the credits and I can save that. Now you see it's saved. So now you'll see all these buttons on every screen are going to be highlighted, include intro, outro, and credits. So now I can browse to any video that I have, right? So let's say this is my main video, and I can set an output location, and it does it pretty fast. I'll just put it testing. I'll hit OK, right? And then I'll hit include an intro, include the outro, include credits, and merge. So what this has done is now it's successfully merged that video. So now those intros, outros, and credits are there. But what you'll also see is, let me make sure that this refreshed. Yeah. What you'll see at the bottom here is you have intro, outro, and credits here as well. So if you have a link and you paste the link in here, or you have a bunch of links, let's say you've got 20, 30, and you upload the text file, if you include intro, outro, and credits, every video will be torn down. It'll be rebuilt with the intros, the outros, and the credits, and then pushed to your channel. So it automates that also. And so some tips we have about that, when you're actually a member of Nano Express, in the back, we show you how you can use this technology to actually, take a video, take part one, put a commercial in it yourself, put in part two, and it'll automatically just push up. So it's just another strategy, and we get into that with this automation in the back end when you're a member. The processing screen basically just is where you can watch what's going on. Configuration, this is where you put in your FTP, put in your information, test it, right? I can also, like right now, I'm on my Nano. So I'm on our hosting platform, but I could enable my C point, which was offered by TV Boss, it was their previous version. So I have an account with them and I just put their information in here. So since I'm using that information now, if you go back home, you'll see that I have different channels. And that's because these are the channels that are being hosted with them. So we've got that configuration. We also have configuration for Vimeo. So if you do have a Vimeo account, you can put your information here. We have a whole video on how to get it. It's really simple. But we do have a video on it. You have to take some action with Vimeo to make that happen. FTP, if you have a third party provider that has their own content delivery network or something, and they'll give you an FTP username and password and link, that would work too. And as Dr. Alex alluded to earlier, we are in the final stages of testing out our own content delivery network. So it'll be automated. It can be automated into the platform, much like the our other hosting can. So we have some pretty cool tools, like migration's a great one. If you go into Roku or you go into any of your channels and you go into the feed URL and you grab the feed and you put the feed right here and you grab the where you want it. So let's say I make a new channel. Let's say you have an existing channel somewhere called Houses. So let's say you go home, you create a new channel called Houses, you come here, you select Houses for the channel, you go into Roku, grab your current JSON file, paste it in here and hit migrate. It'll copy everything off that into your new platform here. And then all you have to do is hit show stream on this Nano Boss or Nano Express channel. And when you do that, it'll show you the feed that you have, and you use this feed to paste into your Roku. So it's a pretty automated system to even merge or manage or come over, migrate over if need be. Now, this is really only a last resort sort of thing. Because typically, we connect to anybody. I mean, if you have a hosting account with GoDaddy or anybody, whether it's video like Vimeo or it's GoDaddy or any hosted company, they're always open systems, meaning that they have FTP username and passwords, or they have, APIs or some sort of connection. So typically wherever you are, they have that ability, and then you can just directly connect to them, and then you're reading and writing JSONs to wherever they're being housed. So when you find yourself coming up against a closed system that you have, meaning they have no connection, well, you could just use this system to paste it in and hit migrate. Pretty simple. Another feature we have a help screen, obviously, and it'll tell us, we'll tell you where our training is, but we have this online feature. Hopefully you guys will be able to see this. Currently, it is not online because it's after hours here, but during the week, during business hours, Eastern Standard Time, we have our staff manning this. So if you have an issue or you have a question and you don't feel like going to the members area, all you have to do is hit help and you'll be talking to one of us live, so we'll solve your problem on the spot. So we don't really have a ticketing system per se, because we rather talk to you directly and solve your problem on the spot and then move on to the next one and the next one. Although in the members area, you can post questions in there if they're not emergencies and they're just questions, that we will answer those as well. So that's the way we sort of handle support. Same thing with marketing. We deliver marketing material typically via email or through live chat or in the members area or via the phone. Matter of fact, we have some of our salespeople. Some of our salespeople actually get on the phone and help close customers if that's what's needed. So we have a big group of support. Monetization, simple. You can enable it. Right now there's barons, and we put in exactly what their ratings are and what's needed. We do have other ad providers we're working with, but this is automated too. You can select your channel, right? And you can put your channel feed in there and it'll send it to Barron's, and Barron's can approve it or not based on this qualification. Also, we have a thing called podcasts. This was another user that actually asked for this. If you do have podcasts, you simply upload it, you hit load. It'll bring in any kind of information that the podcast has. You can put a title, description, a tag, upload an image, hit save. It'll combine all this together, and whatever station you want to post it to, it'll automatically post it to it by hitting save and post. I know this is very fast, and the real information is on our Roku channel, but to sit here and demo all of it and show it step by step, there's just so much, it automates so much, it'd be almost impossible for us to demo in this webinar. We'd be here all night. So what I want to do, though, is I want to change my screen just for a minute and show you this, because I want you to know what else we're automating. So hopefully you'll be able to see what we're working on. So these are things we're currently working on adding to the platform. So not only does it have all these tools currently, the current tools that I showed you, but these are the things that we're actually adding. Video hosting, we talked about that and the need for that as advertising dollars are more competitive and video hosting just keeps rising. We found it very hard to make any money just on the advertising end. So we do make money on the advertising end, but we consider that sort of icing on the cake. It's not like our main revenue. Desktop live streaming and mobile live streaming. We're definitely working on that. Live streaming is important to us and it's important to our current customer base. So we're definitely putting it in the application. It's the application you guys would get these updates automatically. We don't sell these updates. If you own the product, you get them. Apple iOS and Android apps. So you know, we are certified Apple developers. So there is some opportunity to actually make Apple iOS apps. And we're looking into that right now to see if we can offer channels on mobile devices so they can stream the content on their phones and iPads and things like that. And we're looking at Android as well. Additional off and online integrations. That's sort of what I showed you earlier. Online meaning, you know, the Facebooks and the social media, because what you're going to have here is one platform that streams to everything. So basically, you'll do the work once, decide where you want to share it, put in your credentials to those other applications, hit go, and it'll just do it for you. Allowing in-channel purchases and offering subscription-based channels. That's not done with Direct Publisher, but we're putting in using through the SDK. So our customers will actually be able to sell things on TV or offer their channel for X amount of dollars per month. So we're working on that. Content randomizer. I can give you a sort of, you know, a little foray into something like that. And we'll explain it when you become how it all works when you get in the group, become a customer. But we have a way that we've attracted customers with a great deal of content, basically almost an unlimited amount of content that they create themselves. It's part of just what they do on a daily basis. Problem is you know, with the Direct Publisher, the limit is 1,000 and they need to randomize their content because not a lot of people are scrolling over, especially if you have that volume of content. But they are very popular. They're a very key customer of ours and they're a partner of ours. So, you know, we're trying to really work this in so it randomizes the content. So if somebody comes to your station today, they'll see videos that are in the front, but if they come tomorrow, they're switched. So it appears to the user that they're constantly having fresh content because it's moving it around. Another thing a user brought up is that wouldn't it be great if you could upload a watermark and just have it on videos, like pick the opacity or, you know, what you want it to look like, and it would automatically put it on the videos. We're definitely doing that. We think that's a fantastic idea. Media server integration. We are trying to build up a media server because we do have some pretty big customers, and they all want to host their own. A lot of them want to start hosting their own type of commercials and things. So we're putting that together. Additional advertisement opportunities. I can let Dr. Alex talk more about that, the people that he knows and he's been talking to. We have a thing called Channel on the Web, which we can integrate to different websites. That's definitely in the works. All the social media integrations in the works. And so is an automated full web portal where it will not just spawn the channel, it'll spawn a web page for the entire channel, and it can be locked down or hidden, so it's not open to the public. But there's a lot of cool opportunity with that. I know this has been fast, and I know there's been some issues with people seeing the right slides and whatnot. But it will be replayed, and we do have a lot of videos. It was supposed to be on sales and marketing, so I'm not sure why it didn't switch. So I will hand it back to Dr. Alex. I'm sorry the thing was brief, and I'm sorry that the technology just didn't seem to work very well for showing the content.
Thank you, Brill. Well, I could see your content changing on my screen, so I think that maybe it was a problem for some people. I don't know if that was a problem for all the people. But certainly we will be including, more slides or more videos if there is anything that we missed out in this one. So what I wanted to tell you is that it's really the passion that led us here. And this is an opportunity, but I'll share what I think about opportunities. Well, I think that opportunities are everywhere. This is not the only one of them. There will be opportunities tomorrow, the day after. There are only two problems if you miss on the opportunity. Well, they're sometimes very hard to spot. So even though they are there, we might not see them. And therefore, we might not act on them. And that is the second problem. Even if we see the opportunity, it could sometimes be hard to act on it because we are involved in something else, because we are too busy at the moment, and for any number of reasons. But in my mind, there is no doubt that, with this software and with the current state of the on-demand TV industry, this is an enormous opportunity for you. I wanted to show you a couple of slides here, just as an illustration of what is the typical response of so many businesses when it comes to change conditions. Do you know what this really represents when the conditions change, when the old strategies stop working? Well, that's when lots of people put a lot into marketing, and I see that the letter G jumped onto the next line, sorry about that. So the red bar would represent the marketing and the development and support, they suffer big time. With this is just the opposite, imagine when you have all three, when you have lots of software development going on so that you have a perfect automation tool. Imagine when the support is terrific. And when you add the marketing component to it, well, then there are really no weaknesses. And if you don't have the proper development and support in place, then you have to have the fantastic marketing because you're flogging the inferior product. And let me tell you, it is possible to do that too. For instance, some of the movies that come out of Hollywood are fantastic, and there are some that are just plain terrible. Well, the marketing is now so good that, even if the movie is a horrible one, they can find enough angles to bring enough people the very first weekend and make enough money to make big profits before people start talking about the movie and tell other people not to go watch it. That's all it takes. In the internet marketing community, well, let me tell you, I've seen lots of smoke and mirrors lately. And in fact, you know, a few weeks back, I bought some social marketing software, wanted to see where we are at the moment. And it was very, very little about the software itself. Instead, they were showing, you know, one guy making money, then another guy making money, then another guy making money, you know. So you start thinking, oh, they're all, you know, making so much. I'm the only one, you know, here not using it and missing out. I had to have this software. And then they were piling bonuses, one bonus, second bonus, third bonus, fifth bonus, you know. So you think, ooh, I'm getting so much. So I bought that software. And let me tell you, 1 week after that, when I wanted to talk about this in this presentation, I could not even remember the name of the software. And the all of those bonuses, I ended up junking my hard disk. If I need 50 bonuses before I make the first dollar, well, it's just too hard. It's just too confusing. What really is needed is simplicity. Simplicity that only automation and integration can give you if you are going for multiple clients, if you're going for multiple channels on multiple platforms. The good news is, you know, with the level of integration and automation that is available today, you can easily do it. How do you monetize the channels? There are multiple ways to monetize it. Now, we are running out of time. I can't really go into details, but you have TV ads, you can have paid channels, you can run infomercials, you can promote your products, affiliate products. You can sell the channels. Now, Brill could perhaps tell us about his experience with Azul a little bit later. There is also the weapon called the triple win method, incredibly effective, that involves no selling whatsoever. Really great method that would allow you to quite easily gain clients. We have another weapon that is called advertising multiplier that applies to all of those who want to make the income by running TV advertising. That's a brand new way, and let me tell you, that's the way that can only be done through automation. There is no other way to do it. And that's something that is explained in detail, you know, to all the people who get this piece of software. So what do you get? What do you get with Nano Express? Well, of course, you get the Nano Express software. You get the step-by-step video tutorials. You get all the marketing materials that you need. You get awesome support, really terrific support. That has been the sticky point of so many launches that I have seen recently, that everything goes into the marketing, support suffers big time, people wait for a week, 2 weeks, 3 weeks. Sometimes they never get, you know, the answer to their question. So in this case, support is really, really terrific. You get the access to Nano Automation community on Facebook. You get the two big weapons that allow you to really make a killing in this industry. And finally, you get the IREC locally marketing department working with you, helping you out every step of the way. So you're never on your own. You will know exactly what you need to do. In a moment, I will show you the cost, because at this stage, you're probably wondering, you know, how much could this possibly cost? Well, it doesn't happen every day that you have the software of this quality. And of course, it takes the entire team of the professionals who are on top of their game to be able to pull something like this off. It's not something that is easy. But there are only two licenses that are available, and that's the Nano Express license, which really is the agency license. It allows you to create unlimited channels, not just for yourself, but for your clients as well. So not just for yourself, but for your own customers as well. Channels that are running on multiple platforms. And there is the second license as well, and that is the Nano Express Suite license, and that is the equivalent of the white label, because it allows you, if you don't want to manage the channel for your client, you can give the version of the Nano Express automation software to your clients that only works with that one channel. And that version of Nano Express has your branding. In other words, you have everything that you need to develop this into a major business. And let me tell you, getting clients is just incredibly easy. I wish I knew about those two methods before, because they would have made a big difference in my case as well. You will also notice that one thing that is missing is there is no single channel license. And even though with the marketing that Brill and his team have in place, they could easily sell 100 channels per month, but they want to focus on supporting you, supporting the agency, supporting the white label. And of course, there will be people who want to purchase the single channel. Now, they will be sent to you guys. In other words, Brill is not there to compete with you, but to help you. And having said all of that, what I would like you to do is to perhaps go to rranklocally.com and have a look at the pricing that is available over there. What Brill is doing is giving a terrific discount for the people of this webinar, for the people on this call. And let me just go through those licenses, because in my opinion, this is the fantastic pricing for what this gives you, for this software gives you. It doesn't happen often that you only need one single client, one client, in order to make it work, in order not just to recoup the investment, but to make profits. So with Nano Express, which is billed monthly, it is $147 per month. With the Nano Express billed yearly, it's $970. You're actually saving $794 this way by paying immediately for the whole year. Now, the single payment, this is not something that is often included, because you know this requires the ongoing support. But in this particular case, for people who are serious about going into business and creating the one-off investment, it's only $1,970 right now. And finally, we have a subscription, which is $1,470, and that is for the people who go with the suite. Now, the suite, it gives you everything that Nano Express gives you, and also gives you, as I mentioned, the way of providing other people with the copy of the software that is your branding and that only works with one single channel, so that they can continue managing and running that channel on their own and without your involvement. Sometimes, when people give you the ability to sell one channel or two channels or great many channels, there would be the minimal price that you are required to pay. But there is nothing like this with this particular piece of software. So you have the full freedom to choose the price. However, the Brill and his team are going to tell you exactly, you know, what the pricing range is, what sort of clients to go for, and what is the exact strategy that they have used to build the income of between $13,000 and $14,000, very, very quickly, in practically no time. In order to lock in this discount, you need to go to nano.irankLocally.com/special. So that link is right there underneath. It's called nano.irankLocally.com/special. There are lots of questions that we received during the presentation. So after the presentation, I will also go through the questions and Brill will go through the questions answering them. But before we do that, I wanted to tell you that rather than give you all sorts of bonuses that are going to clutter your hard disk, something that you are not going to do anything with, here is the bonus that actually makes sense. And that is the cloud feed hosting. You can host the feeds, you can host the thumbnails using the Nano Express hosting, which is usually $20 per month. That is going to be completely free for a year. And that is definitely a bonus that you can use. Now, keep in mind that the usual channel would have between 30 and 40 videos, but with the automation software, it's going to be not 30 or 40, you know, 300 or 400 would be more likely, and in much, much shorter amount of time. And for that reason, the hosting requirements are considerably greater than for tiny little channels with only few videos. So this really is the terrific bonus that is being supplied only to people on this group. If you go to irankLocally.com, you will find it over there. It's just being charged as a separate item. I also wanted to tell you something else. I mean, I tell you here that you should focus, that you should not get distracted. But really, I mean, I too am guilty of buying too many shiny products. I'm guilty of dissipating my energy in too many directions. If you look at my JVZoo and Warrior Plus accounts, it's ridiculous how many products I bought over the years. It's page after page after page of products that I have purchased. Front ends, one-time offers, one-time offer two, one-time offer three. I ended up buying them all. We have all done that. But the problem is, you know, that we end up not using those packages. Well, this is not something that you do not use. And with those packages that I have purchased, well, let me tell you, very often they would come with the money-back guarantee. So the marketer tells me, hey, I'm taking all the risk. There is the 100% money-back guarantee. But of course there is a risk. If I waste 2 weeks of my life trying to get something to work and it does not work, what do I care about, you know, whether I got that money back or not? Because no one is going to give me that time back. And that is the only commodity that is in short supply. We are all running out of time. And we all need to protect it any way we can and not waste it. Now, you don't want to waste your time. And Brill does not want his team to guide and support someone who is not serious about turning this opportunity into a major source of income. We are talking about subscriptions here. Now you can opt out at any time. And if the software, for whatever reason, does not work, if Brill's team cannot help you, now of course that you will get your money back. But guys, you get a top-class support. This software is not something that you buy and then leave together dust on your hard disk. this really is something that you act on. And here is the second guarantee that, in my opinion, is something that very, very few would give you. And this is the strongest possible guarantee that you can possibly get. You see, there are closed systems, half-open systems, and then there are open systems. Systems that are closed, well, they do not integrate with other systems. They try to keep you in one spot. With half-open systems, they provide you with API, they provide you with software development kits so that you can integrate, so that you can have, you know, software working together. And finally, you have the open systems that are not just fully integrated, but that allow you, you know, to take everything that you have created and move that elsewhere. And this is the system that NanoExpress represents and will always be. So let's say you spend a couple of months, you create a number of channels, you put lots and lots of videos in them, and you decide, hey, I would really like, you know, to take those channels and leave. Well, with NanoExpress software, all it takes is, you know, a few minutes. All you need to specify is the URL to the content feed, and the software is going to transfer the entire channel whenever you want it to be. In other words, you're never ever locked into place. You're never locked into using a technology without the ability to take what you have created and go elsewhere. And to be, you know, any sort of money-back guarantee usually goes for a month, in some cases 2 months. Now, this is really the lifetime guarantee, because even if you spend a year, 2 years, 3 years, or just 1 month, you can take your channels that you have created, absolutely everything. Click and transfer the channel wherever you want and continue to run it over there. So that's the difference between the closed systems, half open systems, and completely open systems such as NanoExpress. You wouldn't find very many open systems like this one that would allow you to do something like that. So what I would like you to do is to seriously consider this opportunity, to go to nano.rnglocally.com/special and make use of it. And the Brills team will be there to work with you. And my role here is the liaison between you and the Brills team. So if you have ideas, what is that can be automated in your business, please talk to Brills team or talk to me. And I will make sure that those ideas are formulated so that I can then present them to the Brills team, and they're the ones who put all of that into motion. Now, having said all that, I can see that there is a number of questions, and perhaps Brill, you could take over, and because I haven't had a moment to look at those questions while I was presenting.
Absolutely. So I want to go, so I'm going to look down the chat here. But I know there's a lot of questions about, this is a lot of questions for you, I think, Dr. Ives, about your relationship with TV Boss. So I want to tell you about iRank Locally and our relationship and what we've done and how we, you know, how we are related or not related. So basically what happened was I was, a while ago, and still, I have TV Boss, not Fire, but the old version, and we were looking at it, and we thought, well, we should automate this for our customers. So we started automating it, and we kept automating it, because that's what we do for a living. We automate software for some of the largest companies in the United States. So then we automated, and we got this thing. So then we thought, you know, we should bring it to the TV Boss group so they could see it, because we know what a wonderful thing it did for us. We thought, wow, this is going to be great for everybody. So where I found was Dr. Alex. And I reached out to him and I said, hey, you know, if you give me a little few minutes of your time, I would like to show you. I would like to show you how our automation works and how powerful it is, and tell you a little bit about how we use it to make money. He saw it, he liked it, so he took it over to Craig and them. And I don't know if you've seen the webinar that I did with Craig and everybody over there. And then basically, you know, I was setting up to launch it, and there are some talks about, hold on, you know, let's launch it in this way or that way. Again, I'm a software guy, you know, our group is software people. And it hadn't made it to our marketing yet, because our marketing, they're not digital marketers, they're real marketers in the field, meaning that they go out and they figure out plans to sell it in the local community to make money for these channels. And I'll share with you in a minute a couple of things that we do and how we make money doing it. So so then Dr. Alex, and this is where he can take over, and Craig had communications about when we're going to roll it out, all these things. And you know, previously, when I first addressed the TV Boss group, I thought, you know, because all the stuff I saw was Dr. Alex, and that's why I was able to get a hold of first. And so Dr. Alex decided, wow, you know, this is something he really wanted to get behind because of the automation and not. And I'll let Dr. Alex take over if there was a breakdown of selling it inside the other group. And then I'll come back and explain to you how we make money with the software. So just hang tight. Dr. Alex.
Yes, I'm back. So let me have a look at some of the questions over there. So here is one question saying, how many channels come with Nano Express monthly? So the answer is unlimited. You can have as many channels as you can humanly handle. Now, here is another question. Who has a 1,000 videos of content to upload? Okay, well, you have multiple ways to get a content. One of those ways is to go for the Creative Commons videos. Creative Commons videos allow you to use them commercially. You just need to acknowledge the original author of the software. And I'm going to give you four places that you can use right now to get Creative Commons videos. When you get them, it becomes just a matter of curating the content. In other words, you can set up your categories and you can start putting the videos in there. With your introduction, with your outro, and you need to include the acknowledgement of the original author. But apart from that, you're free to use Creative Commons videos commercially. So here are the four sources that I use. There are a lot more, of course, but I'll just go with four that really are quite major. So one of them is Vimeo. If you go to Vimeo.com, do a search for the topic that interests you and then filter it so that you get Creative Commons videos, you're going to end up with quite a number of videos on the any given topics that you can use in your channels. Another place that I use quite frequently is called Pexels. So it's P-E-X-E-L-S.com, Pexels.com. Completely free videos over there. So Pexels. Another place would be to actually search the Creative Commons. And the address there is search.creativecommons.org. Creative Commons, that's one word. So search.creativecommons.org. When you do the search over there, well, you're searching directly from the Creative Commons website, and you can, let me tell you, you can get lots and lots of Creative Commons resources that way, including the videos. And finally, number four would be Pixabay, and you will find that some places give you not just the videos but the images as well. So Creative Commons images, it's exactly the same thing. You can also use the images. However, you need to acknowledge always the original author. That's in the Creative Commons license. So four places: Vimeo, Pexels, search.creativecommons.org, and Pixabay. Here is the next question. How does one make any real money based on the new status of Roku ad dollars going away? Well, there are certain channels that are doing quite well. And when I talked to Jim Larkin of Barron's Media, and they're the advertising company that supplies the ads for the channels that are running on multiple platforms, he identified some types of channels that are creating a lot more income than the others. So let me give you some of them. Well, news channels. News channels are right now at the very top of the list. So news channels are very much sought after advertisers. You can have high percentage coverage of your inventory, and you can also get better rates if you have a news channel. How-to channels are also in high demands. Now people want to be able to do all sorts of things, and how-to channels that, that focus on one niche at a time are quite popular. Number three, entertainment channels are doing quite well, and interestingly, podcasts. Apparently, some people would just like to sit there and listen to the podcast, and for that reason, Brill and his team allowed you to make podcasts now, right now, with the Nano Express software. So podcasts are included as well. Apart from that, there is the method, that the brand new method that can only be achieved through automation that we will be talking about in the members area for the people who go with Nano Express. But let me tell you, you know, that is the real multiplier when it comes to the ad revenue. So not only will it automatically calculate the duration of the video, not only will it automatically put the ads every 7 minutes, but it does some other very clever things that can only be done with automation. However, in the experience that is not just mine, but the experience of many people, the problem of video hosting is still there. It will be resolved soon, but right now the problem is still there. And if you have channels that are very popular and generating, you know, quite a bit of money through advertising, you are running the risk of Video Pro, if that's where you're hosting your videos, or Video Pro coming to you and saying, hey, you know, you need to give us 1,000, you need to give us actually many thousands of dollars if you want to keep this going, because the traffic is not being generated through the video player. That's the only way they can guarantee you the unlimited bandwidth. So the solution that Brill and his team are working on, it is still some weeks away for the video hosting. Once this solution is available, you will be able to go full tilt into this particular way of generating the revenue. But meanwhile, it's the experience of me, and not just me, that there are better ways than going for TV ads that will allow you to get there. Now, Brill, would you like to say something about the Zoo and how they use the
Yeah, I'd like to talk. I know there's been a lot of questions about what we'll do for our customers and what we do. So we go out on test markets. So I want to make this very clear. So for example, this week, and I'll be totally candid with you, we did the Columbus Zoo. They're actually getting ready to have a show on Nat Geo called Into the Wild with Jack Hanna, very popular, very famous. We have a method of getting into these zoos. Of course, we don't want to do this across the country or world, because we're really developing the software and want to get other people. So we will help people to understand how we do this so they can do it too. The zoo pays several thousand dollars a month. They have not just thousands of videos, quite honestly, they have tens of thousands of video. They have tens of thousands of videos about gorillas and, you know, giraffes and all sorts of stuff. So I know there's questions earlier, like, where do you get the content? So we'll get our content through third parties, but not through third parties that are necessarily Creative Commons on YouTube or things like that. We have a very good strategy of going into places like this and actually closing those deals. And what's great about the software, and the only reason we're able to do that, quite honestly, is because with the suite package, you get that commercial version. Think of that as your controller. And so you get another piece of software that we call Nano Select. It's just like the commercial version, except for they can't add and remove channels and things like that. All they can do is manage their own channels. Because the whole thing's white labeled, whatever your company would name or your logo or whatever you come up with, the whole application would look like that. I think I posted a picture actually of another niche that we exploit and will teach our customers to exploit. If you go on the Facebook group, you'll see that we have a white label that's called Z Promo. That's another great avenue. They actually are a promotional company that they already sell to businesses. And they already have, you know, we just closed those guys probably 2 weeks ago for that market. They already have 13 salespeople that are around, and they already have established business relationships, and they sell promotional products, meaning things that'll spread advertising and things like that. So we were able to use the suite product to say, okay, we're gonna white label for them so they can control as many channels as they want, but they go find a customer. And that customer, they create the channel for the customer, and they give the customer the select version. The customer runs it himself. To address another question at the same time, it's easy to do because it's all point and click, just sort of like Windows is. You know, back in the day, there were computers before Microsoft Windows. See, what happened was, though, Windows came up with a way to make it usable for people, everyday people, just by pointing and clicking on things. And of course, they went through extensive like marketing and gave it away in schools and all those kind of things. But the reason that there was such a boom in personal computing was because of the ease of personal computing. This is the way every product and every industry goes. You know, somebody comes up with the technology. I know Dr. Alex had worked on it, you know, the 70s or 80s or a long time ago. I don't even know when. And then you have people that come around and they speed it up, they automate it, and they reuse it. So what's great about it is so now the zoo, the Columbus Zoo, which they already have the channel, they're actually next week, they download the software. It's all customized for them, of course. But they're not getting any other customers. They're just feeding their own. But they pay us a monthly fee, several thousand dollars, honestly. And the reason they do it is not just to promote the Columbus Zoo, but because they know that it's a new technology. And they know if they didn't go out there and swipe up their own names on these platforms, some 16-year-old kid would or somebody else would, and they'd be posting who knows what. So it was important to them to go out and get these various names of the various zoos and all these kind of things and actually get it going. They make their money, obviously. They don't even want third-party advertisement because they have partners like Children's Hospital, here, Nationwide Insurance, which is another big corporation here, Kroger's. These are all partners with the zoo. So they are already paying for the application. So the zoo is, in fact, using it for free. So this is one solution. The Z Promotions or the promotional products market is another solution. We have kind of easy ways, sort of automated ways to contact these people, get in the doors, and we've tested what exactly to say and what to do. You'll meet our customers, whoever becomes a customer, will meet a guy named Chris Schrader, and he is our head of marketing. They've got a team, but he will work with you and talk to you and even help you make these calls to get you set up at the zoos or at the chambers. That's another system we have, or at the promotional companies. So we have a lot of markets. So when asked how we make our money by being able to give the software to somebody that can give it to somebody else. I'll throw it out there. Listen, the Chamber of Commerce, the Chamber of Commerce in every city, they have hundreds of businesses that are members. So the thing is, with our software, we give the select version to the Chamber of Commerce. They run their own channel for the city for all the businesses. Well, we started doing that, but then some of the businesses wanted their own channels. Well, they contacted us directly to get their own channels because they didn't want to just be on the city channel, they wanted their own. So we charged them a monthly fee for that as well. So we have a lot of ways that we go about making money. And the reason we're able to do that is because we have the technology that we can give the client, and it's very easy for them to use just by pointing and clicking on things. So I really wanted to address the relationship. I hope I did that clearly. We are very candid about everything. You can ask anything you want. We will tell you everything that we know. I tell you about our marketing, what we do, how we contact them, and why we're able to do it. And the reason we're able to do it is because of our automation software. We can actually give out to third parties and they can use it, and they're doing the work for us while they're paying us for that service. So we really like that. Now I want to address one more question that's up here. Can it do special characters? Because German language and Spanish, they have special characters. No, we do not allow special characters, but what we are doing in the next version is we're putting in the different languages. So when you see the A, the U, the O, those won't be considered special characters. What we'll consider special characters are like your smiles and all that kind of stuff. Yes, Lou, we do. We have a whole pricing structure. We actually, what happens is if you have it, you'll work directly with Chris or Ethan or somebody else in the marketing team, and they'll actually look at your area and city that you're trying to take on, and they will figure out a demographic and a pricing structure that'll be successful in your area, and they'll work with you to actually get up. Because the goal is for us, just so you know, and there's no guarantees, but our goal is with every person that gets on our software, we want to help them get their first one channel, because that will be more than enough to pay for the channel. And hopefully it'll be enough where you guys will understand how to get the second, third, and fourth. We do not charge for updates. Now, if you need additional storage or you need something like that, we would charge for a service like that, but updates, no, we do not charge for updates. It's part of the package. We are here. You know, we are not looking to go around and sell this to a million people. We're just not. We're looking to sell it to a few hundred people that really want to build a business, and we want to help them build their business. That's it. That's why there's no fancy marketing offers here and all that kind of stuff. We're going to shoot straight. We're going to tell you what it is, and we're going to help you out as much as we can help you out. This is what we know how to do. This is what we've done. And we were a TV Boss customer, and we still are. We connect to you saw in the demo. Well, maybe you didn't see because of the lag and everything. We still connect to their FTP service. We didn't upgrade to Fire or anything like that, but we do have a TV Boss account. We connect to that, and you know we have videos and everything else up there. I'll tell you how much monthly bandwidth storage do we get for $20 a month. So here's the thing. So the $20 a month, that is for now, and that's going to hold holds all your thumbnails and all your streams. So we'll get this to while David, I'll let you, Dr. Alex answer that question for you. So we can have an unlimited streams and unlimited thumbnails for your $20. It doesn't hold videos right now. And full transparency, we'll probably have the video hosting out within the next few months. The reason for that is we were a victim of the Vimeo coming and sending us that email that nobody wants to get. We had a channel, we call it Bigfoot Hunters, and we put it up because we were working as a demo. For some reason, it started to get a lot of plays. Then Vimeo sent us a letter and said they wanted X thousands of dollars, and we said no. And so we closed it down because that's not really what we're trying to do anyway. We're just trying to actually, dev the software and beta test it. So then we thought, wow, that's crazy. And that's super expensive. And we have relationships because, like I said before, we developed a lot of automation. Companies developed a lot of automation for, things like FedEx and places like Visa, like a lot of that backbone we had our fingers in. So we've done it for very big sort of global companies. And I thought to myself, we already have relationships with data centers all over the world, quite frankly. And so what I did was I started making calls. And so now we have data centers where we have servers several different data centers, and we've started to develop our own software and our own CDN, and that'll be a lot less expensive. So the offer for the $20 a month when people buy, I mean, they'll probably never pay that at all, quite honestly, because they'll probably move over to our video hosting. And although our video hosting would be wanted by everybody that's ever been a Vimeo customer, because it'll be a fraction of the price, and it'll be just as fast, and it'll be in a completely open system that anybody can connect to it in any way, any time, and it's portable, meaning you can press one button and take all your data, move it away from us, and move it to any platform you want. The reason we make it portable is because you'll never leave, because our system actually does what we say it does. And so we have every confidence in the world of the platform, the system, and the need for the video marketing, the video hosting. But the deal is, only people that are actually customers are going to actually be able to take advantage of our video live streaming, because again, we're not trying to be Vimeo. It's not what we're trying to do. Live streaming is coming. Scott, I see that just off the top. It's not there yet. But again, everybody gets free updates. So what happens is, everybody that's a customer, you know, every probably 30 days, you'll probably get an email from us saying, download this, because you'll have more features. And there won't be, oh, for this one-time offer, this cost. That doesn't happen with us. We don't do that. We want to help you grow your business. And we price the product fairly. We have a lot of development costs. We have a lot of support costs. And that's why we can be there for you on the telephone. That's why we can remote to your computer and help you set things up. That's why we can be there for you and help you get your first group of clients. So I hope that's really candid. I just wanted to make sure I was very clear. I want, from everything from relationship and where we came into the picture, and you know, what we do. Do I need TV Boss if I buy the program? If you have TV Boss, the legacy one, you can use their FTP to connect there if you like. It's not, ours is a standalone system that can connect to any third party, as long as it's an open system. If you have Fire, I don't believe it can connect to Fire. That's something I don't know if they're considering opening up to let anybody communicate with it. How can I reach out to you? Scott, here, I'll tell you how everybody can reach out to me. It is brill@irankLocally.com. There's woody@irankLocally.com. You go to the website, there's a phone number, we answer that. So you can email us, you can call us, get us on the Facebook group. But if you're a customer, the best way to do it is you will get a log into our members area, and the whole company hangs out there. So if somebody says they have a problem, everybody helps. I don't care if it's marketing. We don't care if it's technology. If that happens and it comes to me, I will go find that person, and I will make sure that they will help the next person or help you, or there will be repercussions. We are not a remote company. Yeah, you can talk to us on the phone. That's right, Keith. We're always available. We don't have remote employees. They're not all over the world. They're not uncontrolled. They are in a building in Grove City, Ohio, where we run our entire company. They are here. They come here 9 to 5. This is who we are. So we're unlike probably what you're used to dealing with. We're very different than that. We're an automation company that got into this arena and brought to the attention of Dr. Alex, and he brought it to the attention of Craig. And then for whatever reason, they decided who was going to sell it, who wasn't going to sell it. I don't really know that. And I don't know about Dr. Alex retiring or anything like that. Maybe he was going to and saw the application and he's just like, okay. But I'm not going to speak for him. So Dr. Alex, if you're there, there's some questions. I think I've answered most of the questions for me. But I think there's some questions about people thought you were retiring or something like that.
Yes. Well, the news of me retiring.
Dr. Alex? Is anybody with me?
Can you hear me?
Can you guys in the chat hear me?
Can you hear me now?
I hate to think I was talking to myself this whole time.
Brill, can you hear me?
Okay. Thanks, Keith. thanks. I'm not sure how we dropped Dr. Alex. But we're here to answer any questions that you need answered. So if you have any more, just let me know. I'm not I'm not a super big marketer or anything, but I know what we're willing to do. I know what we have done. I know the successes that we've created with the software, and we are wanting to help a group of people do this across the country. Because at the end of the day, I mean, if you buy into the products, you've actually, I can't hear Dr. Alex. Can anybody else? I'm sorry, I'm reading this. Cannot hear you.
Now, can anybody hear me, guys?
Oops. Well, I still can't hear him, so I'm going to continue to talk, I suppose.
Can anybody hear me?
Okay, so I'm going to let Dr. Alex talk then, and I'm going to put mine on off, even though I can't hear you.
Okay, guys, so I'm just going to make the assumption that you actually can hear me, because it seems that Brill can't. There are a few more questions that I would definitely like to answer, but we have been over 2 hours, so it really is getting late. So in regard to be retiring, well, I'm definitely scaling down my business involvement very considerably. I'm a single father who has a two-year-old. And as such, you know, I need more time to spend with her. And also, I like being independent. And I'm no longer part of the TV Boss project, for that matter. When it comes to Nano Express, well, I am not employed by Brill's company, but I'm definitely there to help you with your automation needs, to help you formulate those needs and then pass them on to the Brill's team so that they can put that into action. So I no longer have any products. The c-point.com website that was mine for $20 is now Craig's. So this is, I guess, as close to retirement that I can come, which means that my business activity is significantly lower than it used to be in the past. However, I have lots of experience in this industry. I've been in this industry for a very long time, and because I'm independent, I can definitely help you make some good decisions. Well, Brill's solutions when it comes to video hosting, they're shaping up to be really good ones. However, if another, even better third-party solution becomes available, well, you will be the first to know. Now, other questions. Does it matter if it's HTTP or HTTPS in the URL? I think that you're probably referring to the address of the content feed for your channel. It doesn't matter whether it's HTTP or HTTPS. It does not have to be encrypted. Next question, let me just see it very quickly. Is Nano Express, can it be used independently? Yes, it can be used independently. You have the video editor that is built in. You have, however, it's an automation tool that integrates with other systems. So, I mean, of course, you also need the Roku account. You need the Roku device. If you're going to support that platform, you need the device for the Apple TV. But yeah, it is an independent piece of software. Next question would be, can you host videos from Amazon AWS S3? Well, the quick answer is yes, you can use Amazon S3. However, S3 is for storage only. That really is not for streaming videos. When you combine that with Cloudflare, with Amazon Cloudflare, so that you can stream videos, that becomes a very expensive solution. And that's actually how I started. I started by using Amazon S3 combined with Cloudflare. I was hit with a very, very big bill in the first month, and then I switched to Vimeo Pro, which worked quite nicely for a while. Well, now that is becoming a problem, but those other solutions are on the horizon and will be available very, very soon. The next question was, can you use Will there be a step-by-step demo of creating a JSON? Well, yes, there will be, and this software actually automatically creates the JSON. So let's say that if you want to upload the video from your computer, what you will do would be click to upload the video. The software can then automatically add the intro if you want to, the outro if you want to. It can add the credits video to the end if you want to. It will automatically calculate things like the bitrate and the duration of the video and everything else. And in the end, it will auto-create a JSON file that you supply to Roku. If you're running the Roku channel, it creates the XML feed that you supply for your Fire TV, Amazon Fire TV. It creates everything that you need for your Apple TV channel. So that's essentially how the software works. What was there a falling out between Dr. Alex and the others? Well, as I said, I'm scaling down my involvement in the business. And I quite like being independent being able to recommend the best video editing software, the best automation tools, the best, you know, way to generate products and so on. Okay, any more questions? How many channels come with Nano Express? Well, as I said, unlimited. You can create as many channels as you wish. Let's do one more question. And the question is, can you store things on Google Drive? Now, guys, if you are storing your videos on your Google Drive, keep in mind that you need more than just a storage solution. You need a video streaming solution. And for that reason, Brill and his team, they already have three data centers, two in Europe, one in the United States, and they're very busy testing everything, setting everything up, providing live streaming, the ability to do the live streaming as well. So that will be one way to host your videos and have them hosted with unlimited bandwidth. The other way is to host your videos on Vimeo Pro. Now, for as long as your channels are not incredibly popular, Vimeo Pro is a solution that works at only $20 per month. However, as I said, they have that clause that says that it's unlimited bandwidth only if you use the Vimeo player. And so for that reason, super popular channels need a different solution. There are also some other solutions that are discussed in my Facebook group, which is Dr. Alex TV group on Facebook. That's the community of business owners, of people who want to run online businesses. And multiple solutions are being discussed there when it comes to hosting your videos what the options are, what the costs are. There is more than one solution available. When one solution for hosting your videos, for example, is to go with a cheap storage, and there are lots of cheap storages around that are charging 1 cent or 2 cents per gigabyte. And then combining that with the content delivery network, there is one that I identified. The name of that content delivery network is Bunny CDN. So just write it down, it's Bunny CDN. And they seem to be quite reliable. Their pricing is very favorable. That's a company that is based in Slovenia, in Europe, but with data centers around the world, they can, of course, provide the streaming to everywhere. So there is more than one way to host your videos, but you normally would not just have it on a device that is used for storage, because you need something that is actually going to stream your videos at the sustained rate. Now, I see that we are well over 2 hours. Guys, we have to stop here. any more questions, well, we have them in the chat. So with what we are going to do is just look at all of those questions, put all of those questions together, and then answer them through the email, through the newsletter, or by going to the Dr. Alex TV community. So thank you for coming. Thank you for listening. I do hope that you took quite a lot out of this, whether you end up using this particular software or not. If I was able to help you with some information as to where to get the videos that you can use for your own production, where the opportunities are, where some of the challenges that you need to address, if I was able to help you with any of this, I'm very happy that that was the outcome. So once again, thank you very much for having you. Thanks for coming, and see you soon in the group.